China from the moon? You'll find out as one of these three contestants wins the chance to drive home in this brand new Pontiac 6000 STE in just a split second. And now, here's the star of our show, Monty Hall.
Thank you. Welcome to Split Second. We've been having a lot of fun on the show, giving away a lot of prizes, a lot of money, a lot of cars, and learning a lot of things, too. Now, for example, the first question today that you saw at home. The fact of the matter is that astronauts only a few thousand miles up in space cannot see any man-made objects on Earth. They've said so. People think that they can see the Great Wall of China, so that no. So if you were going to take a spaceship to see the Great Wall, cancel your reservations. I don't know whether it's refundable or not. I'm not quite sure. But you can't. It's amazing. You can't. I thought that from way up there they could see all these things, and we've heard about it, but apparently we were wrong. Does that bother you, that you can't see the Great Wall from outer space?
No, I've never been up there, so I'm not going to worry about it yet.
But I thought that you could see into the future and stuff like that. So they were going to learn more about this. Young lady was our returning champion as Sandy introduces the three contestants to us on today's show.
All right, Monty, first we do have our returning champion, our sociologist, who also has an artistic bent, Dianne Craig. And next, a young man who has turned his love of film into a profitable side business, John Simeon. And on your right, a mother and flight attendant who keeps her spare time on ice, Patricia Titeran.
Let's find out something about our contestant, Dianne. We know is our returning champion. She won the last time, trying for a second championship today. And you were doing all kinds of wonderful work and looking at applying certain techniques that we have today into the field of tomorrow. What can you tell us that we can look forward to?
Oh, well, they're trying to bring back the picture phone. They've got a trial going on in Germany for the past few years to see if that will work. Before, a lot of people didn't want to have to see the person that was calling them in case they were caught at the wrong time. But they are trying to see if public acceptance will want to bring that back.
I wondered about that. You know, the phone rings and say, wait a minute, makeup.
Yeah.
Before I answer the phone.
Uh-huh. And banking from home. Banking.
Well, banking from home is a definite thing that's going to happen.
Yes, it's coming. There's several different ways they're proposing to do it, so they're deciding right now.
Best with money.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Thanks, Dianne. Now, John, you sort of made a face when you were introduced. Did we mispronounce your name?
Yeah, it's Italiano. Yeah. Simone.
Simone. Simone. Simone.
And the way Sandy's you said it, Sandy get was it after the show.
Right.
You know what I mean?
It's Simone, and the way you said it, Sandy, was phone. John, I'll pronounce it right. Always, it's Johnny.
It's Giovanni.
Giovanni. Can I call you Giovanni through the show?
Well, it's actually Giovannone, Big John. Or Giovannino, Little John, but I'm Giovannone.
Yeah. Okay, Sam, I'll be with you a little later on. Patricia will find out something about you a little later on. We're going to have a lot of fun. We have three great contestants on the show today, and we'll see how well they do in our fast-paced show called Split Second. Now, every time we ask a question, there are three answers that come up with it. All you're required to do is come up with one apiece. And if three of you answer part of the question, you get $10 each. If two of you do it, it's $25. If only one of you answers, it's $50 for that person alone. You buzz in as soon as you see the full question on the screen, but not too fast. Because if you buzz in to beat the other people and you haven't seen the question yet, you'll be locked out. Are we ready? Here we go with round number one. I'm going to tell you a few things about three funny fellows who are making movies today. Pick a set of facts and name the funny guy it pertains to. Look at the screen. One of them won an Oscar for The Producers, one starred as Young Frankenstein, and one won a Grammy for Wild and Crazy Guy. Dianne.
One Grammy for Wild and Crazy Guy, Steve Martin.
Steve Martin is right. John?
One Oscar for writing Mel Brooks.
That's right. Patricia?
I don't know.
Starred as Young Frankenstein was Gene Wilder. Did a great job on that picture, too. It was one of the funny ones. So we have Dianne and John, the only ones answering. They get $25 each. Nothing for Patricia. I have a shopping list, and I'm not sure if everything is spelled correctly, so check my shopping list for me and tell me if these sauces are spelled correctly or incorrectly. And there they are. There's Worcestershire and teriyaki and Tabasco. Are they spelled right, Dianne?
Yes.
Which one?
Worcestershire is spelled right.
Worcestershire is spelled correctly. John?
Teriyaki, yes.
Yes, and Patricia?
Tabasco, yes.
No, Tabasco, no. You see, she fooled you. She said they were all right, and you took her lead. Tabasco is T-A-B-A-S-C-O, and it was the only one that was not correct. So, Dianne and John, $25 each, and Patricia is scoreless. In sports, all teams have nicknames. Some are colorful. That is, they are a color. So give me the colorful names of these three teams. Look at the screen. In baseball, there's the Cincinnati something, in the hockey, the St. Louis, and football, the Cleveland something. Dianne, give me the colors.
Baseball, Cincinnati Reds.
Cincinnati Reds is right. John?
Hockey, St. Louis Blues.
Correct. Patricia?
Football, Cleveland Browns.
Cleveland Browns, you're all right. You get $10 apiece. Different medical tests are given to patients to check specific parts of the body. I'll give you the names of three tests. Pick one and tell me what part of the body does it specifically check out. Look at the screen. They are the electrocardiogram, the pupillary reflex, and the electroencephalogram. Dianne.
Electroencephalogram checks the brain.
Correct. Patricia.
Electrocardiogram, the heart.
Right. And John?
The reflex, the eyes.
Correct. All three are right. All three get $10. Right now, Dianne and John have a slight edge. Patricia could come from behind. When the lady of the house is as funny as her comedian husband, what does she do? Well, she works with him, that's what. So I'm going to name the comedian husband. You pick one and give me his wife's equally famous first name. Look at the screen for these old-timers whose wives worked with them. John.
George Burns, Gracie Allen.
Gracie Allen, yes. Only the first name is necessary, but Gracie Allen was right. And Dianne?
Fred Allen,
No, Patricia, can you give me any one of them?
Pass.
You didn't know Jack Benny's wife? Mary.
Right.
Mary. He used to say. And you didn't get that one. Fred Allen, you say, Portland Hoffa. And so John is the only one who scores, and he gets $50. And he has the lead by that 50. We know that the equator is an imaginary line that circles the globe. But tell me, yes or no, does the equator run through these countries? Does the equator run through these three countries, Kenya, Brazil, Indonesia, Patricia?
Kenya, yes.
Correct. John?
Brazil, no.
No, it is yes. The answer is yes. And Dianne?
Indonesia, no.
Indonesia, yes. And Patricia, you're the only one who scores, and you get the $50, and look what we've got going for us now. John has a lead, and the two girls are tied. O.J. Simpson has plugged many different products on television and other areas of the media over the years. I'll name three products he is or has been associated with. You give me the trade name. Look at the screen. He's advertised a rental car, a cola, and an orange juice. Dianne?
Coca-Cola.
Wrong. Patricia.
The rental car Hertz.
Correct. John.
Cola, Dr. Pepper.
No, RC Cola, and the orange juice was Tree Sweet orange juice, and he's kind of angry that you don't remember his products. But you did remember he put you in the driver's seat there.
Who's Joe Namath?
$50. That's right. It was probably Joe. Now look at the score. Patricia and John are tied for first. Dianne is trailing. Here's one for you, John. Christopher Columbus is called the Discoverer of America. And these three items concern his first trip to our shores. Pick one and give me your answer. Look at the screen. It is the queen who made the voyage possible, the name of his ships, and the one that didn't make it back home. John, give me one answer.
Queen Isabella.
Queen Isabella is right. Dianne.
The name of the three ships, the Santa Maria, the
I'm sorry, Patricia.
The Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria.
That's correct. And the one that didn't make it home, for your information, was the Santa Maria. It was wrecked on a reef. And so John and Patricia get $25 each, and now have $145. Dianne, our champion, has only 70. Seems that everybody's on a diet these days, but here are some fat folks who enjoyed fame and fortune because they were fat. Name them. Look at the screen. There was a silent movie star, there was the man in the Maltese Falcon, and the one in Cat in the Hot Tin Roof. Patricia. Any one of them.
Fatty Far, I don't know.
You don't know. Dianne.
The fat man in the Maltese Falcon.
I'm sure
silent movie, Fatty Arbuckle.
Fatty Arbuckle is right, John. And listen to this. The fat man in the Maltese Falcon was Sidney Greenstreet. And the big daddy in a cat on a hot tin roof was Burl Ives. And so John is the only one who got it, and he gets $50. And at the end of the first round, he leaves with $195. The 52nd is $145. Dianne, our champion, shares with $70. We'll be back in just a moment.
I'll do this is if I get the big
driver.
Too tough.
You think I'm worried about this fool, man?
Too sexy.
Look at all this potential out here.
Brian, they're gonna kill you.
I think they messed with the wrong two guys.
Too fast, too furious. Tomorrow at 9 on Game TV. You're watching Game TV.
Think Wonga.com will be a hit?
Absolutely. Canadians can now get a short-term loan on their terms.
Fast little loans your way.
Precisely, Betty. With Wonga.com, you decide how much you borrow and for how long.
We tell you the total cost up front, and the money can be in your account in as little as an hour.
Speaking of hits, what's listening to? Oh? This beat makes me want a crumpet.
Wonga.com, Britain's innovative short-term lender, is here.
Kitty.
His name is Mr. Cuddles.
Sure. Here, Mr. Cuddles.
Go to my...
When you feel like a king, you deserve the spicy, angry Whopper.
Your turn. His name is Mike. Here, Mike. I got you.
When you really feel like a king, you deserve an angry Whopper combo. Only $7.99 at Burger King.
Where am I?
Enjoy Canada's favorite coffee at home, one cup at a time, with Tim Horton's new single-serve coffee cups, compatible for use in Keurig K-Cup brewers.
Talking to Dianne and John, and now a word or two with Patricia. At the beginning of the show, Sandy said something about you spending time on ice. What did he mean by that? Are you a skater?
No. As a matter of fact, I can't even tie up my skates tight. My sons are in major hockey, and I live in arenas.
Oh, and you have to take those kids. Sometimes they play games at 6:30 in the morning. And
yes.
Do you get up with them and go
yes.
with those hours? Well, you're a devoted mother to do
I
that.
Thank you.
I had a friend whose son was a figure skater. And the only time they get ice time was 4 o'clock in the morning. Can you imagine getting up and taking your kid at 3 o'clock and having him skate at that hour? And, yeah. and mother sitting there saying, oh, boy, could I need my sleep. That's devotion. Are the kids good hockey players?
Very good.
Did they love it?
So far.
Well, then it makes it all worthwhile, doesn't it?
It does, thanks.
All right. Now, John, the only thing we found out about you is how to pronounce your name, but I didn't even ask you what you did.
Well, I'm an actor and a photographer. I love Fellini films. Especially La Dolce Vita with Marcello Mastroianni.
Wait a minute, if that's one of the questions today, he knows all the answers.
Because he's a paparazzi photographer, and that's what I do.
Right. Well, yeah, I must tell you that I'm not too thrilled with the paparazzi photographers, because no matter what restaurant you go to, they're always there jumping in front of your nose and taking
fame.
Pictures.
It comes with fame.
It comes with fame. Well, thanks for explaining it to me, John. All right, now we're going to go to our second round. And in our second round, we double the stakes, which means that if three of you are right, you get $20 each. If two of you are right, you get $50. If only one of you is right, you get a $100 all to yourself. You're playing for the money, which you keep, but more important, for the advantage in the countdown round, which determines who goes for the car. So if you're ready, here we go with the second round. Great musical conductors can handle popular music as well as classical music. I'll identify three conductors who prove that statement. Name them. Look at the screen. We give some clues. The conductor of the Boston Pops from 1930 to 1979 and wrote the score for West Side Story, and the present conductor of the Boston Pops, Dianne.
1930 to 79, conductor of the Boston Pops was Arthur Fiedler.
That's right. John.
West Side Story, Bernstein.
Right. Patricia, the present conductor of the Boston Pops. John Williams. John Williams also wrote the score for many of those big space movies, too. An excellent composer as well as conductor. So Dianne and John get $50 apiece. And now the score is John in the lead. Patricia still second. Dianne is gaining. Most of us know that there are 9 players on a baseball team, but how about these sports? Pick a sport and tell me how many players there are on a team. Look at the screen. John.
A volleyball, 6.
Volleyball, there are 6 players on the team. I'm not counting the substitutes that come in out, but when they play on the field. So, Dianne, you're second?
Water polo, 12.
No, water polo is not 12. Patricia?
Water polo, 9.
7 on a volleyball team. And a Canadian football team, there are 12. American football team, there are 11. The Canadians have 1 extra. And so, let me see. John, all by yourself, $100. Maybe the girls can make a comeback now as we turn to food. When you go shopping in the supermarket, you better know what type of vegetable each of these groups describes. So pick a group and name the vegetable involved. Look at the screen. We give you some clues. Boston butter, acorn, crooked neck, paprika, pimiento, John.
Paprika is the tomato family?
No, I'm sorry. That's not right. Dianne.
Acorn crookneck squash.
Correct. Patricia?
Boston buttercup lettuce.
You just got it in time. You started talking while the buzzer was sounding. The last one, paprika and pimientos in the pepper family. So I'm sure you didn't get that, John. Let's modernize ancient history. I'll name a group of people and the land they were in, they were from in the olden days. You tell me what country they'd be in today. Look at the screen. A Spartan in Sparta would be where today? A Trojan in Troy and an Aztec in Tenochtitlan. Dianne.
An Aztec in Tenochtitlan would be in Mexico.
Correct. John.
Trojan in Turkey.
That's right. And where would a Spartan in Sparta be today, Patricia?
Italy.
Yeah, not a good guess. Greece is the answer to that. Dianne and John, $50 each. Now we'll talk about tools. Some tools are used for metal, and some tools are best for wood. Look at these three tools and tell me which tool is normally used for what, metal or wood. Look at the screen. A hacksaw, bucksaw, compass saw. Dianne.
A hacksaw for wood?
No, wrong. I'm sorry, John.
Hacksaw for metal.
No, either or, you can't go for it.
Bucksaw for wood.
Correct. And a compass saw?
Metal.
No, wood. Only John. $100. He knows his saws. Let's go flying. I'm going to describe three things that require an answer that includes the word flying. So pick a description and fly high. Look at the screen. Here are the clues. A Wagnerian opera, something that has the word flying in it. Chiang Kai-shek's American Force and the U.S. Bomber. Dianne.
The U.S. B-17 Bomber Flying Tiger?
Flying Tigers, right. And John?
Opera Madame Butterfly?
No, I'm sorry. And Patricia? The Wagnerian opera is the Flying Dutchman.
It's not Wagner,
and the U.S. B-17 Bomber was known as the Flying Fortress. Dianne picks up $100. And is in second place. Dance teams have hoofed their way to success from the days of vaudeville to the days of television. So here are the first names of famous dance teams of the past. Pick one and give me their last name. They are Marge and Gower Watt, Adele and Fred Watt, Vernon and Irene Watt. Dianne.
Adele and Fred Astaire.
Correct. John.
Marge and Gower, no, nothing.
No. Patricia?
Pass.
Marge and Gower Champion, Vernon and Irene Castle, who were the models, I think, for the Astaires to follow. So, Dianne, you get another $100, and you're right behind John now. A signed copy of someone's work is always more valuable. I'll give you the names of three famous people. Pick one and tell me if you owned a signed copy of their work, what would you own? Look at the screen. If you owned a car, said John's a Pinter, what would you own, Patricia?
A car. I don't know.
Dianne?
If you owned a car, she'd own a photograph.
That's correct, John.
Pinter would be a play.
Pinter would be a play, and Jasper John's is painting. It's art. So Dianne and John get $50 each at the end of the second round. John is in the lead with 545. He will have the advantage of the countdown round. Dianne is second and Patricia's third. We'll be right back.
Are you tired of those hot, sticky, sleepless nights? Are you fed up with flipping your pillow looking for relief? Some nights you feel like you're on fire. Introducing Chillo, the amazing new pillow pack that transforms your pillow into a Chillo. Look, pillows trap body heat, increasing perspiration, but Chillo keeps your head cool and dry. The secret is Soothe Soft technology, the water-cooled memory foam that keeps you cool for hours. He likes the room hot, she likes the room cold. Chillo was customized to cradle you in memory foam cooling comfort. Even if your room feels like a desert, you'll feel like you're in a cool oasis. Watch, these thermographic images show significantly lower blue Chillo temperatures, but the down pillow is many degrees warmer. Chillo fits perfectly inside your pillowcase or sleep right on the slip-proof cushion.
When I suffer from a migraine, I usually use an ice pack. It tends to leak and create a mess. But with Chillo, it's so much more comfortable. It makes me feel better instantly.
I've been experiencing hot flashes and night sweats, but with Chillo, it's instant cool, instant relief, and it's wonderful.
Every night I used to wake up in a puddle of sweat. Chillo really helps spread that coolness around, so now I feel comfortable.
There's more. Cool Soothing Chillo is a perfect cool compress for headaches, migraines, backaches, or even throbbing, aching feet. Frigid ice packs lose their cool, but Ultra Suede Chillo lets you chill out all night long. Look again. Chillo stays almost 10 degrees cooler. Now order the amazing Chillo for the special TV price of just $19.99. But wait, call in the next 10 minutes and we'll send you a second Chillo as a bonus. Just pay separate shipping and handling. You get it all, two Chillos for just $19.99. So call now.
To order, call 1-800-941-5720. That's 1-800-941-5720. Or visit chillo.ca. Order now.
is in the first 2 rounds you were playing for money, and John picked up 545, Diane 470, Patricia 195. But now you're playing to see who goes for the car. The countdown round is next. This time, you can answer when you buzz in. You can answer one, two, or all three parts of the question. And we give you one mark for every time you're right, and you could, the one who goes down to zero first is the winner. John, you're in the lead, so you only have to answer four questions. Diane is handicapped by one because she's second. She gets five, and Patricia is handicapped to a six because she was trailing. So she has to answer six questions, and the one down to zero first will be the winner. Remember, you can answer all three parts when you buzz in. Here we go. You'll find Captain Queeg in Herman Wouk's novel, The Caine Mutiny, right? In what works would you find these captains? Look at the screen. They're Captain Nemo and Andy Hawks and Captain Wolf Larsen. Where would you find them, Diane?
At Jules Verne, Captain Nemo, Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea.
Not Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea. That is not correct. And John, your second.
Jules Verne's 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. You may continue, John.
Jack London, Moby Dick.
No, I'm sorry. Can you give me any, Patricia? No. The other answers are Jack London's captain is the Sea Wolf, and Edna Ferber's captain, Andy Hawks, is in Showboat. And as an actor, you may play in that someday, John. So take a look at the score. John needs 3, Patricia 6, Diane 5. Nobel Prizes have been won through the years by people who also won political elections. I'll give you the Nobel Prize and the year and some facts about these winners. You give me their names. Look at the screen. Lots of information about each one of them. Let the audience at home take a look and see them as well. And now you pick one, Diane. You're first.
Peace, 1919, U.S. President, Teddy Roosevelt.
No, I'm sorry. That's not right. John?
Former British PM Winston Churchill.
That's correct. You may continue.
Peace, 1919, Roosevelt.
No, that was not right. And Patricia, can't give me any. And it's Woodrow Wilson as the one in 1919 and Theodore Roosevelt in 1906. Everyday news reports are filed from the capital cities of America, of African countries. So pick a capital. Name the African country it's in. Here are the capitals. Nairobi, Tripoli, Rabat. Give me the country. Diane.
Tripoli. Nairobi, Nigeria.
No. John.
Tripoli, Libya.
That's right. One more and you've got the game.
Nairobi,
Patricia? That she just can't join us today, can't she? All right. The others, Nairobi was Kenya, Rabat was Morocco. You still need one. I'll give you the titles of three TV series, theme songs that became record hits. Pick one, name the series it came from. Look at the screen. Here are the songs, Keep Your Eye on the Sparrow, Believe It or Not, Welcome Back. Can you, you're in first, Diane.
Believe It or Not, The Greatest American Hero.
Right.
Welcome back. Okay, Welcome Back, Welcome Back, Carter.
Right,
Carter.
Continue.
Keep Your Eye on the Sparrow.
Can you give it to me, John?
Keep Your Eye on the Sparrow. No.
Or Patricia. Barretta was the name of that one. Diane needs three, John needs one. I'll give you the names of three formerly independent states that are now parts of other countries. Pick one, name the country they are now a part of. Look at the screen. Serbia, Bavaria, Estonia, and Diane, you need three. You're in first.
Estonia, Finland.
No. John, what
Bavaria,
part of the country?
Germany.
Bavaria
East Germany.
Is what?
East Germany.
No, I'm sorry, that's not right. And Patricia, can you give me any?
Bavaria, West Germany.
West Germany is one. Can you continue?
No.
Estonia is part of the USSR. Serbia, part of Yugoslavia. John still needs one. Diane needs three. Patricia needs five. I'm going to show you the logos that identify three major airlines of the world. Name the countries that run and own these airlines. Look at the picture. Diane, you're in first.
KLM Holland, JAL Japan, and the bird is Lufthansa.
Lufthansa is right. You've got all three, and you've got yourself another chance. What an incredible finish. What an incredible. Here is John. He just if he said West Germany instead of East Germany, you've had a one. And, oh, that's how close it was. John, what can I say? You were a great contestant. I hate to see you go.
Thank you
are going to take away $545 with you, and thanks so much for being with us. Thank you, John. Very good. Patricia, you had a tough time. Sometimes it's tough under those lights, isn't it, to answer questions?
It's warm.
It's warm and tough. But there's $195. Sharpen those skates for the kids. Make them good hockey players. Diane, come with me for the second time. Diane is a champion and is going to try to win this beautiful automobile.
PeteWonga.com will be a hit.
Absolutely. Canadians can now get a short-term loan on their terms.
Fast little loans your way.
Precisely, Betty. With Wonga.com, you decide how much you borrow and for how long. We tell you the total cost up front, and the money can be in your account in as little as an hour.
Speaking of hits, what's listening to? Oh?
This beat makes me want a crumpet.
Wonga.com, Britain's innovative short-term lender, is here.
Dull skin, sun damage, age spots, dark marks. They all add up to a less than perfect complexion, but your skin could look so much better. Introducing a skin-saving secret from Proactive that's designed to help fade the appearance of discoloration, brighten skin tone, and erase the look of dark marks and sunspots to give you beautiful, flawless-looking skin. It's our brand new Dark Spot Repair, and we'll rush it right to your door when you order your Proactive pack today.
Proactive really was this complete package that worked together to not only get rid of my zits, but make the rest of my skin glow and even out my skin tone. And now I am truly, truly, truly in love with my skin.
Before Proactive, my skin was dull, and now I can't find a zit, and it's more even and it's soft. It's wonderful.
Order Proactive for only $24.99 Canadian, and we'll include the amazing Dark Spot Repair, a $36 value. Plus, for a limited time, your shipping is free.
I started noticing changes, you know, after 1 or 2 weeks. Now my skin is buttery and rich with an even tone, and it's got the healthy shine to it that I just love, that I didn't have before Proactive.
Developed by the dermatologist who brought you Proactive, the Dark Spot Repair helps fade the appearance of dark marks and discoloration for all skin tones. Let Proactive and the Dark Spot Repair give you the flawless, even skin tone you've always wanted. Results guaranteed or your money back.
Sometimes people go, oh my gosh, you have such beautiful skin. I'm like, I use Proactive. That's what got me a clear skin.
Act fast to get Proactive and the Dark Spot Repair plus these great free gifts. All together, a $90 value for only $24.99 Canadian. Even better, order today and your shipping is free. Call the number on your screen or go to getproactive.ca today.
When people compliment me on my skin, I'm like, yeah, Proactive. They're like, no. I'm like, yes.
You're watching Game TV.
This beautiful Pontiac 6000 STE can be won by Dianne Craig right after this. Automobiles for the staff. Split second provided by Ontario Rent-A-Car. For dependability and reliability at a reasonable price, big or small, we rent them all. Ontario Rent-A-Car. Accommodations for Monty Hall and the split second staff provided by the Toronto Hilton Harbor Castle. Toronto's only downtown hotel on the lake. Featuring first class dining in the award-winning Chateau Neuf, the Toronto Hilton Harbor Castle. The car on today's show was provided by Addison Cadillac, the leading General Motors dealership in downtown Toronto. Addison on Bay. Models Wardrobe by Loggers, a statement in fashion.
Well, Dianne, you're a two-time champion, and again, you're going to try and win this beautiful automobile. And last time you were here, you chose screen number 2, and so we're going to black out screen number 2, and now there are 4 screens left. The car is definitely behind one of the 4, 1, 3, 4, or 5. What is your guess today?
Number 1.
Number 1 is the one that she wants. We'll take a look at number 1, turn it around, and see what's back there. We turn around. Is there a car back there for Dianne? No, there's another $1,000 in cash for her winnings. Where was the car today? The car was over here in number 4 position. So you add another $1,000. You're up to $3,035. You come back to play again with 2 new contestants and see if you can win again next time. We'll improve the odds. So say goodbye to everybody right now. Dianne, thank you. Congratulations. Here's Giovanni over here. Thank you. Giovanni, thank you, dear. Good luck to your hockey players, too.
Split Second is a Stephen Hayes, Monty Hall production in association with